हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। हियर माय सेल्फ मिस्टर जायसवाल किशन फ्रॉम सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एंड वी आर लर्निंग ऑल अबाउट स्ट्रक्चरल एनालिसिस। लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर टुडे सेशन ऑन फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी मेथड। सो नाउ इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी कंसिडरिंग सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑन फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी मेथड। लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो देर आर वेरियस कैटेगरीज ऑफ एग्जाम्पल, सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ बीम, देर आर सम अदर एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर फ्रेम्स, and we'll be also having an examples on truss. But now in today's session, we'll be considering an example on beam. Let's see. Now here, analyze the beam by flexibility method and draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Now here, beam is given on which various loading is given. Now here, as you can see, this is a fixed support and this is a roller support. So how to proceed with our example? First of all, we will release our beam on the basis of SI, structurally indeterminacy. So let's find SI. So first of all, we will be finding SI, statically indeterminacy. So on the basis of statically indeterminacy, we will be release our beam, and then we got our redundant, and then we will proceed to the example. Let's see. Now here you can see SI, statically indeterminacy for the given structure is 1. Like as here it's a beam which resists 3 reactions, vertical reaction, horizontal reaction and one moment. So 3 over here and 1 over here, which is vertical reaction only. So total 4. So 4 minus 3 is nothing but 1. So this is my number of unknown. Our unknown is 1 only. So here we will be releasing our structure, means making our structure as SI equals to 0, means statically determined structure we are making. So here I have released this support and I have named as C support and placed redundant as Q1 as a kind of reaction. So here you can see I have placed fixed support as it is, loading is given as it is. Now here what I did, just removed my support and placed redundant over there. Now we have to find this redundant, and on the basis of this we can find another values, like as reaction at A, moments, and then at later we will be drawing the diagrams. So now how to proceed, let's see. First of all, we will be making diagrams which is bending moment diagram due to given loading. Now here there are two loadings are given, which is one is UDL and another is my point load. So one by one we will be taking loading, and on the basis of that we will be drawing diagram. Now here, as A is my fixed support, so we will be taking resistance at support A only, which is fixed support, and taking moment over here. Now here, as you can see, first we have took UDL. Now here I have written that M diagram due to UDL. Now this is my capital M. Wherever I will be use capital M, that will be related to external loadings, and wherever I will be using small m, that will be related to the redundant. So here capital M diagram due to UDL. UDL is my external loading. So now here you can see it starts from here and till here. So how much? 20 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 2.5. So I will be getting 250 as a value. Now I have drawn it as a parabolic shape, because in UDL the bending moment will occur in curve shape. Now we will be making diagram for point load. So I have made for UDL, now another is for point load. So it starts from here and we have taken resistance at A. So the distance from here to A is nothing but 6. So 25 multiplied by 6 is nothing but 150. So from 0 to 150 as a straight line, because for point load bending moment diagram is a straight line. So we are completed with our external loading bending moment diagram. I would like to repeat that this diagram is for UDL, which is nothing but 20 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 2.5, and this diagram is for point load, which is this 25 kN, and the distance is for 6 meter. So 25 multiplied by 6 is nothing but 150 kN into meter. Now as look, this all loading, both the loading is right side of the section. So it is going in clockwise direction. So I have took it as a negative diagram. Now we will be moving towards the redundant diagram due to redundant. So let's see. Now here our diagram is triangle because I have placed Q1 equals to 1. Here I have written 1 unit load as a Q1. So 1 multiplied by total distance, which is 7. So 7 kilonewton into meter is my diagram of unit load. So this is my small m diagram due to unit load. Small m related to my redundant. And always we will be taking redundant as a unit as per its formula. Apply unit load and find the displacement. So that's why I have applied a unit load over here and then drawn its bending moment diagram. So again it's a point load, so straight line. Now our formula is Q equals to F inverse into dq minus dql. So this formula we have learned in the very first session of flexibility method, the theory's portion and its concept. So we have to find our redundant Q. So for that we have to find F flexibility method and dq minus dql. Now as I explained that dq is nothing but displacement corresponding to q1 and q2. Means here I am only having q1, so I will be only considering q1. So displacement means in the question itself there is nothing given like a sinking. Here it is written if sinking is given. So if there is any sinking kind of thing given, then our dq value will be coming, otherwise we have to take it as a zero. So there are only one number of unknown, so there will be dq equals to dq1. If there are two unknowns, so dq1 and dq2. If three unknowns, so dq1, dq2 and dq3 as on. So here right now we are having only one unknown, so dq1. So we are considering it as a zero because no sinking is given. Now next is dql. dql equals to dql1. Let's see. Now for dql1 we have formula which is capital M multiplied by small m upon En. So what is my capital M? It is this external loadings. And what is my small m? It is my this unit load diagram, which is my redundant diagram. So now capital M into small m upon EI, so equals to 1 upon EI, I will take constant. Now we have to find moment. So we will be considering this diagram as a loading, and then to find moment, load into CG means area into CG. So the first, this parabolic triangle. So we have to take reference from C point because our redundant is at C point. So the area of this parabola is nothing but 1/3 base into height. So 1/3, our base is 5 multiplied by 250. And I have took this minus because this figure is in negative. So area is nothing but 1/3 into 5 into 250. Now we have to took CG. So CG we have to took from point C, and also side by side we have to look over the diagram of small m. So our CG from here to here means the this cubic parabola CG will be somewhere over here, and the distance is 3/4. So 3/4 of 5 plus 2, because we are taking reference from C point. So that's why it's CG becoming 3/4 of 5 plus 2. So this is nothing but just similar like conjugate beam method. So we are following that method only. So we just did area multiplied by its CG. Now next is for triangle, the point load triangle. Look, here the area is nothing but 1/2 base into height. So base is 6 and height is 150. So minus 1/2 into base into height multiplied by, we have to take reference from C point. So 1 plus the CG will be 2/3 of 6. So 2/3 of 6 plus 1. So after solving this, we can find out our dql1. So our dql1 is nothing but minus 46 4646 upon EA. And we have already find out that DQ is nothing but 0. So DQ minus DQL is nothing but this will be converted into plus. So our value is nearly 4646 upon EA. So this is some point value which is nearer to 4646. Now after finding this value, we will be moving towards F. So F is nothing but only 1 cross 1 matrix F11. So as we discuss in our theories and concept that the flexibility matrix will be depend on number of redundant. Here our number of redundant is only 1, so there will be only 1 cross 1 matrix. If our number of redundant was 2, then 2 cross 2 matrix and so on. So right now we are only having F11. The formula for F11 is nothing but small f into small m upon EA. What is this small m? This small m is nothing but small m diagram due to unit load, which is our redundant diagram. Now here we will be taking same area multiplied by CG. So area is nothing but 1/2 base into height multiplied by its CG from C reference is 2/3 of 7. So we will be getting our F11 value as 114.33 upon EL. Now is as per our formula, we don't require F flexibility matrix, we require F inverse. So after making its inverse, it is nothing but EI upon 114.33. Now Q equals to F inverse into DQ minus DQL. So here it is my F inverse value and here it is my DQ minus DQL value. So EI will cancel out. 4645.833 divided by 114.33 is nothing but my value is 40.63 kN. Now what is this? This is my redundant Q. And what was my redundant Q? It was reaction at point C. So this becomes my RC. So we have found out one reaction which is RC. Now we will be moving ahead to find AM and AR. Now look, the process or format of the flexibility method is somewhat similar to stiffness method. So in stiffness method also we were finding AM. Here also we are finding AM. So AM is nothing but AML plus AMQ into Q. And as I said, M stands for moment and S stands for load. So moment due to load. So there are two bending moment diagram of load. One of UDL which was coming -250 and one was with point load which was coming -150. So ultimately our AML equals to -400. AMQ is due to redundant. So that triangle of 7, so our AMQ is 7. And Q which we have found out over here. So after solving this, we got our AM value is -115.56 kN into meter. So now what is this AM? It is nothing but MA. Because A support is my fixed support and only there our moment will resist. So MA, this is my AM. AR is nothing but ARL plus ARQ into Q. Q we have already found out. ARL is nothing but our reaction. So this is due to reactions due to UDL and this is reaction due to point load. So how many number of load is going downward, that the reaction will be its upward. So here it is 100 km due to UDL 20 into 5 load. To convert UDL into load is nothing but length into density, means intensity of UDL. So 20 multiplied by 5 plus this 25 kN of point load. Ultimately our ARL is due to external loading is 125. ARQ, the upward reaction which we have considered was 1, so minus 1. Its resistance to downward is minus 1. So that's why we took minus 1. So AR is nothing but 125 plus ARQ which is minus 1 into this our Q value. So we got our reaction RA 84.37 kN. So by this way we can find our redundant moment AM and AR. So now next. Now here with the help of our reaction we can find out shear force diagram. So this is our reaction at A which is 84.37. Then 84.37 minus UDL into its distance, so we'll be getting minus 15.63. Then for 1 meter, there is no loading, so diagram will be straight. And then sudden point load is coming, so minus 25, so we'll be reaching to minus 40.63. And then again for 1 meter, there is no loading, and then suddenly our RC, so our diagram will be closed. After this, we'll be drawing bending moment diagram. So this is my bending moment diagram. This is my MA, and moment at C equals to zero because it is a roller support which does not resist moment. So directly connect this point and this point. Now here in the shear force diagram, you can see here it is my point of contact action. Also here it is in point one. So at these two points, we have to find moment, which is my moment at D at this point and moment at E over this contact action. So for that, we are assuming that AB is a simply supported beam in which summation of moment at A equals to zero. So RC multiplied by 7, reaction multiplied by 7 equals to 20 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 2.5, this is my UDL, plus 25 multiplied by 6, this is my point load. So I'll be getting my RC as a 57.1, and with the help of this I will be finding out moment at D and moment at E, so we can draw its reference diagram. So this was the example on flexibility method of one redundant. Let's have a quick revision what we did till now. So first we release the beam, then we find out that primary unknown, then we find out AM and AR, and at last we draw diagrams. So this was the diagram of capital M, which is due to external loading. This is my due to redundant. And as per formula, we solved the entire example. And then at last, diagram.